Before we get into some of the questions that some of the folks have sent in, I just want to get to know each of you a little bit better. Michelle, I've met you a couple of times. I know a little bit about you. But the rest of you guys, I don't know that well. And I want to know what you're studying and what country you're from. Tell me just a little bit about why you chose your field that you're studying as well. So we'll start with you, Tony.
Yeah, do you really want to know that?
Yes, yes please.
No, yeah. My name is Tony, and I'm from the Dominican Republic. And I'm a youth leader. I work with teenagers in the Dominican. And I train them and I disciple them. I usually go to colleges and speak about Christianity. I challenge people to think and to ask me questions about Christianity, and I give them an opportunity to be faced to Christianity. So I believe that Christianity is the truth, and because it is the truth, it will stand over all other religions. So that's what I basically do in the Dominican Republic. And I came to Moody Bible Institute to get a master's degree in spiritual formation and discipleship, because I have a call from God to share with teenagers and to disciple them. And I want to see a whole generation, you know, all about Jesus, that will be Christ-centered, and that's what I want.
That's great. So then, Michelle, I know you've been at Moody how long now?
For one year.
1 year?
Yeah.
So you're starting your second year here now.
Yeah, second year.
And what is it you're studying?
I'm also in a program where Tony Enrichment is, so we're all studying spiritual formation and discipleship.
I don't really know how Richmond got to that program. That's, I don't understand.
You know what, something about Richmond that we don't know.
I'm overqualified? So we know we should wonder about who got to the program and how.
Now we know who we should be Yes. So Michelle, you're from the Philippines.
Yeah, I'm from the Philippines, and I've been involved with a Christian theater company, and we're doing a lot of evangelistic musicals, and I think this program will really help me in strengthening the discipleship of strong Christian leaders in our country, because you know, we're doing a lot of big musicals wherein a lot of people are coming to the Lord because of that, but we don't have like a catch basin wherein all of these people, you know, will come to have, you know, this this growing relationship with the Lord through discipleship. So I think if I will be, you know, trained with that and have that opportunity to learn more about spiritual formation and discipleship, I really believe that that will really help us in, you know, developing Christian leaders, you know, through the people that, you know, come to watch our musicals, and in no time will really produce Christian leaders in our countries.
That's great. Yeah. That's great. And Richmond, what country are you from?
Uganda.
Uganda.
Yeah.
And you're part of the spiritual forming.
As well, yes.
Okay. And so tell me what brought you to Moody. Why did you decide to be part of this program? I know you went through LDP, went to college in your country, as all of you did. And what made you decide to take this next step and go to Moody?
Uganda is a country that is about 75% a Christian nation.
Really?
And we do have so many pastors that are leading the church without any training at all. And so there's so much of preaching scriptures out of context, because people do not have the training and this background and the help that is necessary for a person to receive before they begin ministry, the basic tools for ministry. And so that was such a huge burden on my heart. And I shared with a few Compassion staff members about that. But when Compassion came together with Moody Bible Institute, and they came up with this scholarship called the West Stafford Scholarship, and the objective of that was to help former Compassion children who are out in the community trying to do something, but they needed extra biblical training to be able to accomplish that. And immediately I saw this application, and I saw that there was an opportunity to do a master's in discipleship. I was like, that's exactly what my country needs. And I applied for it, and God in his grace and choice invited me with an opportunity. So I'm here being trained. Little did I know it was going to be me to be trained to go and try to change what's in my country. But he chose me, and so I'm here at Moody doing my best so I can go back and help that.
I love this idea that you guys want to change your countries, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit. I want to get to Jimmy First of all, Jimmy, I want to ask you, are you scared because you're going to be joining these three?
She's here.
As long as she's around, you're okay.
He would not be hungry. So.
Yeah. Sitting at Remesh will tell you.
Because you cook for these guys a lot.
Yeah, I have no choice.
I have no choice. Well, I want to ask Jimmy about your program and your joining Moody here and how excited you are about the program. Mm-hmm. But then I want to ask about this food and stuff that you guys are doing together.
Yeah.
And we'll talk about a little bit about your relationships. Tell me first about your country and why you're involved.
Okay, I'm Jimmy Wambua. Wambua means of the rain. Mm-hmm. I must have been born during the rain season. Oh. It's a blessing in our country.
It's not in my country.
It's floods.
Okay, in my undergraduate training, I did agriculture. I trained on agriculture, so I'm a crop scientist. But immediately I left college. As I was interacting with young people, I realized that many young people really need mentorship. And at the same time, I was trying to interrogate myself, asking myself, what is it that has made me what I am today? And the answer that I was getting from that question is that it was out of well-meaning people who came around my life through their mentorship and discipleship that has transformed me to this person I am today. And the second question was like, what can I do back to help my society and these young people? We are 65% of the 38 million of the nation, 65% is youth. And so I thought to myself and said, the best thing I can do is like to plow back that training that I've got as a leader. But unfortunately with my agriculture training, I needed some extra training, probably in mentorship and discipleship. And so when this Moody opportunity came, it was one of the miracles that will transform that vision into practicality and be able to help young people. By the time it came, I'd already like initiated something called Inspirational Public Speakers. What I did is assemble some alumni from my country and go to schools, high schools, secondary schools, to talk to young people about the same facts. And so this opportunity, when it came, I thought like doing biblical studies will be able to make me well-founded in the Word. And I think the Word of God is the most powerful, overpowering tool that one can use in reaching out to the world.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
And my desire is to systematically study the Word of God. And as Richmond said, we have many leaders back in our country, and unfortunately church leaders who use the Bible content for selfish reasons, and they don't end up impacting people, but rather making people get lost. I'm happy I'm going to study this systematically and understand and be able to interpret these principles, especially to the young people of my nation.
Wow.
That's why I'm excited to be here.
That's great. Yeah. Tell me a little bit about your environment growing up. You mentioned this morning in chapel that there was a point in your childhood where you were considering eating out of dumpsters.
I actually did.
Wow. Tell me what it was like to live in your community. You're from Kenya?
Yeah.
Correct? What part of Kenya are you in? Tell me about that community, and tell me what it was that brought you to that desperation of eating out of a dumpster.
Okay, I was born back in 1982. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, I've never seen my father. Mm. I don't know how he looks like. And I'd lost one of my brothers to starvation. He was 10 years old. And again,
he died when he was 10 of starvation?
He was 10, yeah.
Wow.
Again, I lost my younger sister when she was 10 months old, again from preventable causes, diarrhea, and some starvation condition as well. And so when I was around 4 years old, I looked at the situation at home and said, I'm not going to see this happen to me. And so I decided to be waking up very early in the morning, at around 5 a.m., and make a dash to the dump sites to try and make it in time before the dogs come, so that I can scavenge for the little that I'll find and eat. Simply because my mother had fallen sick that time, and she was not able to fend for us. Most of the time she'd spend sleeping, because there was nothing we could eat. And so for 4 years, I did that. For 4 years. And it until compassion came around my life, that's when I stopped doing that. Actually, by the time I got sponsored, I was looking really funny because I was really skinny and had these protruding stomach conditions to portray Kwashiorkor. And my skin was like jaundiced and my hair strand was like in isolation, very ravaged by poor living conditions. But in 1990, that's when the miracle did happen. By that time, my mother had already like donated us to our relatives to stay with them because we were going to starve in the house. And for her, she traveled like 220 miles away to look for cheap medical care. Fortunately enough, she came back with the good news that this summer I've got some help for you guys. And that's when like our family came back together. And through the compassion screening and food supplements, study programs, they were able to reconstruct my life and like get me back to normal, like a child, normal child. Mm-hmm. I thank God for one thing though, that I was not retarded, because chances would be I would have been retarded in my mind. Mm. But like God came at the right time,
yeah.
Just before mm-hmm. I got ravaged by the condition.
So it's amazing to me that here's this child who from 4 to 8 is eating out of dumpsters every morning,
mm-hmm.
getting up early enough to beat the dogs to the dumpsters.
Mm-hmm.
And fast forward now to a kid who's a young man who's about to start a program at Moody Bible Institute. Mm-hmm. And that's
the miracle.
How did we get there,
Jim? That's the miracle. That's the miracle because, again, the person who sponsored me, it's interesting, was a young person and a young man
mm-hmm.
from Canada.
Really?
And one of the things that I like to ask him when I meet him one day, I hope I'll meet him, is how did he get to choose on me? Because I was not good looking at that moment. I really wish to see that first photo that compassion took on me and then put it as a package there for someone to choose.
Yeah.
But I think this man was moved by God and he did obey God's command, like take that child. The child is on the brink of dying out of preventable causes that you can manage.
What would you say to him if you saw him today?
I'll just thank him for allowing God to use him and accepting to hear God's voice.
Mm.
Yeah, because who would have imagined like 19 years later, this young person or this child faced with starvation will travel yonder into the United States of America for a big opportunity and become like a hope to a nation. Because I believe we are the leaders that God is creating for the next generation.
Mm.
And the change that God wants to do, He's decided to do it with compassion. Because this doesn't happen to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And looking at those many years, I just recently sent Selena a photo of my childhood. And it will really strike you that this is the same person
mm-hmm.
after so many years.
Wow.
Yeah.